Welcome to this episode of Bearcat Chats. I'm Jacob Wilkins, and a pleasure to be joined by Julia Milewski. She's the Assistant Director for Student Transition and Success and a Success Coach. Julia, thanks so much for joining me.
Thank you so much for having me. I'm excited to be here today.
Let's get to families. And we preface this, we know we're coming off of Thanksgiving. Parents, we think you're great. But we know that when you get home, sometimes the dynamics can change. And with siblings too, you're in a smaller environment, it's contained, and parents may find, you know, they can revert easily back to, I call it the high school dynamic, you know. Joey, why aren't you studying more? And you as the student have your habits in place that have been successful. How do we manage parents and siblings?
That's a great question. And I really like to advise students or coach students to just communicate their needs with their family, with their siblings, or even if they're, you know, have roommates, whatever it might look like, that they communicate their needs. So the most basic way to do that is sharing the student schedule with their family. So, you know, Mondays from 12 to 1, I'm on Zoom and I can't be interrupted because I have a lecture and I have to focus in. You know, some of those class schedules are a little bit more finite and easier to share and to set those boundaries. Where it becomes more challenging, though, is that study time. Because, you know, your family might be a great distraction. You like to spend time with them. And so it's hard to kind of pull yourself away from that. I think with that, it's really looking at it as a team approach and thinking, okay, family, I got to get through this and I need your help. Please help me stay accountable to getting my work done and making sure that, you know, if I set boundaries for myself, you're not going to be crossing those boundaries. So if I say Saturday morning, I have to devote to write my English paper, Saturday morning, I don't want to go, you know, have a snowball fight with you or whatever it is. So really setting those boundaries and communicating them clearly with family can be a nice way to approach it.
And that it doesn't have to be confrontational. The idea is you've entrusted me, the student, to be away at Binghamton for most of the semester. And so by nature, I've developed a system. And so let's keep that going. You want to see me do well. I want to do well. We're all invested in my success. And so you're working with me. I'm not telling you.
Yes, that's a fantastic point to bring up. And it really is this, you know, bringing your parents along or your family along, your siblings along in the success that you've had so far. So I love that suggestion of saying, you know, I have this system in place. It's been working for me. Let me tell you about it and how you could be helpful in this situation as well.
How do we avoid Zoom fatigue in terms of how important is it to maintain a workout routine, exercise? At least for me, I find that just getting in a 20-minute workout in the middle of the day, I'm just a little more focused and I can take a deep breath and get back into a project.
Specifically with Zoom fatigue though, some of those practices can be really helpful just to get away from screen time. So something as simple as putting away your phone, stepping away from your computer and preparing yourself a meal. So if it's preparing yourself breakfast or lunch or dinner or a snack, a cup of coffee, something that's going to get yourself away from the screen for 10 minutes, mental break, can really mean, you know, make the difference of if you're starting to have that Zoom fatigue set in. Similarly, like you said, working out, going out for a walk, anything that's going to get you away from that screen time. A lot of times our students and colleagues alike, you know, we get off a Zoom meeting and we go right back to email, or we get off a Zoom meeting and we look at our phones. And I think with students, it's so tempting that when class gets done, I normally would pull out my phone and look at my phone and, you know, check in with things. But again, you're going from one screen to the other. So you're actually not going to feel, you know, any of that relief if you're switching screens so frequently. So having that moment where you step away, you know, working out, meals, taking a nap, anything that can really be that time away from the screens can be helpful in that long-term sustained, you know, being sustained in focusing for your classes.
And I don't have a good answer to this next question. I don't know if anyone can solve it, but usually, at least to me, environment's big. So the idea that if student A was at Binghamton, they could go to the library, they could go to a Starbucks where you're mixing something fun, getting that, you know, pumpkin spice latte, and study. When you're confined, and we're just using the baseline, let's say, you know, everything, no indoor dining, et cetera, wherever they are at home, and we're not encouraging that, of course, they might be confined to an area. So it seems like switching the environment however you can, even if it's tough with the cold weather, to get outside is important.
It absolutely is important. And, you know, when thinking about your environment itself, of is it distracting or not? So I know, as we mentioned previously, of having family members around, maybe you think your brother or sister is the funniest person you've ever met. And they probably are. And if that's the case, though, you don't want them hanging out when you're trying to really focus in on a lecture. So making sure that when you sit down, you know, these next couple of weeks to finish up your classwork, and then, you know, additionally, to finish up those exams, that you're really setting the environment for you that's going to be conducive for focus. Some students find it helpful to have music. So music without vocals, just instrumentals, or just very low-key music, that can be a great tool as well to focus in. Other students find it helpful to have, you know, everything, they set their environment up around them. So they have a beverage, maybe coffee, water. I'm a peppermint mocha gal, not pumpkin spice. So maybe a peppermint mocha, whatever it might be, you know, you have it at arm's length, your chargers for your laptop, your cell phone, everything that you need for that specific study session. And then that way you're gonna feel less tempted to get up and get distracted by your environment around you. So really thinking ahead of time, thinking of your future self, something that you'll hear me say a lot. If you meet with me in a one-on-one meeting or just in any conversation, thinking about your future self and what you're going to need to be successful can really be the nice first step towards getting that, towards that end goal of success.
And just to go back to the tutorial services that are still available, we were talking off camera last week, you know, it's easy to think, oh, everybody knows that it's there, but a lot of students might not realize they need it till they need it. And so where can they go to locate those resources?
Absolutely. So university tutorial services can be accessed through Starfish. There's actually a really comprehensive instructions on the university tutorial website of just exactly how to figure out, you know, which sessions are available to you. In addition to that, there are supplemental instruction sessions, and that's right on our supplemental instruction website. So that is for Dr. Merriweather's Psych 111 class, Dr. Jantz's Psych 243 class, and Econ 162. So all of that information is on our website. And then in addition, if students are having questions of, you know, I need help with something and I don't know who to ask, they can use a function in Starfish. So, you know, right on your my.binghamton.edu dashboard, on the left-hand panel, there's a little blue starfish, and they can actually use a function called request help, and they can ask for help either in a specific course or just in general. So if they have a question in their course, they can use the I need help in a course function and write a little message, and that goes to their faculty member or supporting resources. Same thing with the I need help function. They can say, you know, I need help planning my classes for next semester, but I don't know who to ask. They can put that in there, and then the appropriate resources will reach out to them to make sure that they are connected and getting the support that they're looking for.
And the big thing is, even though students are going home, that faculty, nothing has changed in terms of university operations. Can students still reach out to your office and set up an appointment if they just want a little roadmap for their final couple of weeks?
Absolutely. So I know our office is still hosting, you know, success coaching appointments and programs as well. In addition to a ton of my campus colleagues across campus, you know, all of our services have been easily transitioned, or maybe not so easily, but smoothly transitioned to a virtual format. So, you know, even if you are at home now, most likely, pretty confidently, there are a whole slew of resources still available to you just to reach out through Zoom or through email whatever platform they are using. And one thing just to add in there too, again, if you ever have a one-on-one conversation with me in success coaching or attend one of my workshops, I will always say that college is the only time that you're going to have this many people wake up every day just to help you. So the only exception is if you become wildly famous. So usually I ask students, are you going to be famous? Because if so, you'll probably have an entourage. And but if you're not planning to become wildly famous, this is the only time in your life where you're going to have hundreds of people wake up every day who just want to help you and to see you succeed. So, you know, reaching out, don't be shy. If you have questions, if you have concerns, don't be shy to ask for help because we all want to help.
Julia Milewski, thanks so much. This is so important, and wishing you and your staff a great rest of the semester. And I'm sure that students will get a lot out of our conversation.
Thank you so much. I appreciate it.